Cup final features Roberto Luongo, who gave up 8 goals in Game 3. His worst defeat as a Canuck, and only the third time in his career he's been on for 8 or more. And lost in that final score in the histrionics of Game 3 was the superb goaltending of Tim Thomas, who stopped 40 shots for the third time in these Stanley Cup playoffs. Referees tonight, Dan O'Halloran and Kelly Sutherland, and I don't think any of us would be surprised if they called a couple of penalties early on just to show they're in charge and to settle these teams down if they pick up where they left off. Canucks will start Ryan Kesler and his line mates Chris Higgins and Mason Raymond against Patrice Bergeron, Mark Recchi, and Brad Marchand. Keith Ballard, in his first appearance in the Stanley Cup Final, is on defense with Kevin Bieksa. They're almost going to have penalties called on the opening faceoff.
As Marchand goes after Bieksa, Keith Ballard, what a big role he's going to have to play here with Aaron Rome out. He drives up with Kevin Bieksa, so he's got big minutes against top lines in his first game of the final.
Not only Rome, Dan Hamhuis still out with an injury. Johnny Boychuk and Andrew Barrett are the defensive pair back for the Boston Bruins, and the Canucks get into the attacking zone. Can't get a hold of the puck. Marchand with an outlet. There's a first bump. That was on Bergeron. Marchand streaking down the left wing. Bieksa is right on him. Takes the man. Bergeron in after the puck, and Ballard cleared it before he got to him. Ryan Kesler, center back in support of his defense. Kesler tied up with Brad Marchand. They both went down. A tip at center ice by Chris Higgins. And the puck out of play. And it looks like this will be as fast-paced.
Absolutely, and maybe just as nasty. I thought Game 3 was as nasty a finals game as I've seen in a decade or so. Right off the second draw, there's a good battle going between Bergeron and Kesler. Kesler gets the better of the first one, Bergeron the second, and Brad Marchand coming off arguably maybe two of his best games in a while. Another big hit on Kesler.
Top scoring lines out against each other now. Henrik and Daniel Sedin with Alex Burrows, and they need to get it going against Krejci Lucic and Rich Peverley. And Guelph Ontario gets the start in Nathan Horton's spot. Peverley's been very good in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and in particular in the final, and one of the best forwards against Vancouver. Here's Milan Lucic. Sammy Salo and Alex Edler playing against this Krejci line. Burrows nipped a little play to spring Henrik Sedin. This is a 3-on-2. Henrik holds on and shoots, and that's stopped by Tim Thomas. And Henrik Sedin has been a reluctant shooter, so they'll be happy to see him put one on net. Here's Glenn Healy between the benches.
Well, guys, we watched the opening faceoff. Both teams don't like each other, but it started way before the opening faceoff, and it starts in warm-up. Look at Manny Malhotra. He's trying to take as much of the red line as he can. Bergeron got his butt hanging over the side. There's a couple bumps, and Kesler may be the most hated guy on the Vancouver Canucks, cruising the red line. Couple near pumps.
Canucks off the draw, have their third line on the ice. It was Christian Ehrhoff that got a shot that went wide. Bergeron was just on for the faceoff. He passed the puck to Chris Kelly, and the play's offside.
Jim, you mentioned the fact you have to have amnesia here for Vancouver. You have to remember and still be positive that you're only 2 wins away from the Stanley Cup. You're leading the series. And an 8-1 loss was a bit of a shocker in Game 3, but all the talk for Vancouver was eliminating that. Do what you've done all year long, all playoffs long, respond, get back to your game, and play with some confidence.
As he is often wont to do, Alain Vigneault wants to get the Sedins into the game early on, so he double shifts them here instead of the fourth line. They come out again, and they're up against Patrice Bergeron's line this time, and Chara and Seidenberg, the defensive pair that have played against them.
This might be one of those games, Jim, where the fourth line doesn't get a lot of early ice time for Vancouver.
There's a pass off the boards that Henrik Sedin couldn't handle, and back the puck comes the other way. Recchi left it behind, and that reminds us that there was a concert in here last night, and it's about 30 degrees today, and the ice might not be great. Keith Ballard. Checked by Seidenberg. The puck thrown in front of the net, taken away by Kevin Bieksa as Bergeron centered it. And Zdeno Chara is back for the puck. Up the middle to Bergeron. He tipped it. Bieksa got it, though, and he'll join the rush as the puck is dumped in by Tanner Glass. He makes his first appearance in the Stanley Cup Final as the left winger on the fourth line instead of Jeff Tambellini. From center ice, here's Gregory Campbell. Hangs on, put the puck at the net just out of the reach of Sean Thornton. Vampire with a big hit on Victor Oreskovich. This fourth line for Boston was better than Vancouver's fourth line in Game 3. Haye and Campbell in particular were great penalty killers. There's Gregory Campbell with a pass that missed Payet. Andrew Alberts takes over. Long pass didn't get through. Adam McQuaid knocked it down. Campbell overskated the puck and the play goes offside.
Well, if you're a fourth line player and you get in early, you have to try to bring some energy. And this Boston line, as you mentioned in game three, was very effective. Payet there comes in, and the one thing we've noticed is when you're around the puck and you're going one way, you better be darn ready to be accepting a body check. Everybody finished checks in game three, maybe more so than in the first two games in Vancouver, Jim.
Krejci's line out here against Kessler's line for Vancouver now. Kessler got the draw. Alex Edler has the puck to Sammy Salo. He advances it. Mason Raymond tried to tip it in, but he missed it. And it's an icing call against Vancouver.
The one line that has to be better tonight for Vancouver, the Sedins. You look at last game, game three, they had two shots in net, their entire line. And where were they from? 54 feet and one in the corner at 37 feet. That's not good enough. And tonight, Henrik has his first shot of the series. So the answer lies in that top line for Vancouver.
Especially if they get some power plays.
Those are the guys you want to hit too, right? We saw Raskovich get nailed. 33 and 22 should be targets.
You mentioned the power play. That's one of the reasons in the San Jose series with so many power play chances early. 9 goals for the Vancouver Canucks on the power play in that series. That really got Henrik and Daniels' offensive game going early.
Krejci and Kessler again off the draw. David Krejci's been good in the faceoffs, and he won that one, and the Bruins attacked the net. That puck didn't get through. The second one did, and Krejci was stopped by Luongo. Here's Rich Peverly. Lucic in the slot. Ferentz from the blue line. Big traffic in front. Boychuk shot. That was blocked by Chris Higgins. Krejci up against Alex Edler. Lucic in for Krejci, and that's set of his reach, and Sammy Salo goes after the puck, pushes it up the boards, couldn't get it out. Krejci trying to make a move on Edler. Salo rubbed out by Milan Lucic. Kessler up the boards. Mason Raymond charged with trying to get this puck out. Can't do it. Good shift for this Krejci line. And they shoot the puck in as Higgins took a run at Boychuk. And that shift comes to an end, but a good one for Boston. There's Kevin Bieksa. Lugging the puck into the attacking zone. On Chera, tipped up, no arm goes up. Seidenberg is back. Bieksa stays in deep. Backing him up is Daniel Sedin playing defense right now as Mark Recchi starts out with Bergeron and Marchand. A shoot-in went off the skate of Keith Ballard and out of play.
Well, if you watched Don Cherry in the opening, he talked about the Boston Bruins trying to make life difficult for Roberto Luongo. They did it in game three, and here off a draw, everything funnels back to the net. Lucic gets good position in front, and a secondary chance just goes wide. And Lucic starting to get his skating legs. I thought he was much better in game three. He looked faster, he looked stronger, and here early in game four, trying to lay the body on again.
Max LaPierre won the faceoff. Kevin Bieksa got the puck to Yannick Hansen. Here's Rafi Torres with LaPierre. Shoots the puck into forecheck. First man back, Michael Ryder. Checked by Maxim LaPierre. McQuaid steps in. The Canucks get the puck. Torres, hard centering pass. Didn't get by Thomas Caberle. There's Tyler Seguin back in the lineup because of the injury to Horton. Playing on this line with Chris Kelly and Michael Ryder, who's pursuing Christian Ehrhoff. And Ehrhoff got a hold of the puck. Didn't get it out. Kelly fell down as he tried to turn and dump the puck back in. From center, Seguin. Standing up at the blue line is Ehrhoff, and he made the play, but he couldn't make the pass to LaPierre. Kelly will try and get in again. Passes off. Ryder takes the shot. A blocker saved by Luongo. Yannick Hansen is back for the puck, and he slaps it out into the neutral zone. Sedin line is coming on. Daniel couldn't get the puck. Kelly will dump it in. Lucic is after Alberts, and he runs him hard. Alberts, resilient as can be, bounces off. Henrik Sedin, a shoot-in for Daniel to go after. Stops up, backhander Thomas with a nice save on Daniel Sedin. Here comes Lucic back the other way. Tracked down by Henrik Sedin. Turned the puck over. 3-on-2. Here's Daniel. Takes the shot. Tip. As Thomas made the save, and then Thomas got run into. Alex Edler takes a shot, bounces at the side of the net. Alex barrels in front. Henrik kicked the puck wide of the net. What a pile up in front. Henrik's down below. Zdeno Chara peels himself up off the ice without his stick. And Henrik is about to change.
He had a wide open net there, Jim, and his stick was broken in his hands. It just disintegrated on him.
And all he could do is kick at it, and the puck went wide. Best shift the early part of the game for the Sedins, one of their better shifts in the last couple of games. Here's Alex Hedman. Fourth line on for Vancouver here against the fourth line of Boston. Kevin Bieksa had to handle the puck in his feet, so he dumps it in. Tanner Glass is after Boychuk. He gets the hit in. Another one for Oreskovich. A miss by Malhotra. From the blue line, Bieksa slaps the puck wide of the net intentionally. And the Canucks want to do that and get Thomas moving. And now the puck is pinned to the side of the net. And Thomas got a quick whistle as the puck came loose.
Maybe the referees won't call early penalties, let them play.
And I think that's all right with all of us. Great action. Game four of the Stanley Cup Final on Hockey Night in Canada.
Greg mentioned how tough a game it was for Luongo. Well, they've taken a page out of Boston's book, and they're doing the same thing, making life miserable for the best player on Boston. LaPierre, just a little thing like this, skate to the crease, bump the butt end of the goalie stick, it aggravates you, drives you crazy. And then the last play particularly, gets the net hard, Tanner Glass with a bump, little shot in the head, and during the commercial timeout, Thomas is furious, and had a long chat with the referees about, let me play my game. Well, the game plan's pretty simple early. Hit them.
Referees are letting them all play early on. Bruins win the faceoff in their own zone. Ballard knocked the puck down in the neutral zone. It's shot right back in by Chris Higgins. Mason Raymond on the ice. He has a dozen shots and hasn't scored in the series. Here's Brad Marchand, made a move. Backhander just wide. Almost another picture-perfect goal for Brad Marchand, who scored a beauty in game number three, and it really sealed the deal. It was the 3-0 goal. Now he tried to throw a big hit at Kevin Bieksa, but the puck was gone. Boychuk dumps the puck in. Bergeron in forechecking. Puck got by him, not by the blue line. It's shot wide by Adam McQuaid. Bergeron and Bieksa come together hard. Boston's changing. Some time for Mason Raymond. Not that much, though. Bieksa tips the puck out into the neutral zone. It took a Vancouver bounce for Ryan Kessler. He's tipped up, and Michael Ryder will get the game's first penalty. And Vancouver's power play, 1-for-16 in the series, gets to go to work.
And maybe a little break early for Vancouver as that puck going around the boards hits the linesman, and that's why Ryder ended up in a vulnerable spot. This one would have gone right back to the Bruins defense. Instead, takes a funny bounce off the linesman. Now all of a sudden Ryder's trapped, and down he goes. Brad Marchand was on fire at the start of this playoffs. 5 goals and 11 points in his first 11 games, and had only one in the next 9. While he followed up an excellent effort in game 3 with almost scoring another beauty there.
His Vancouver power play 0-for-8 in game 3, so much so they didn't even use the first unit late in the game when they had all of those penalties. The Sedins weren't even on it. They had the puck here. Edner knocked the stick out of Gregory Campbell's hands. Campbell goes to get a new one as Ehrhoff dumps the puck in. The Sedins and Ryan Kessler up front. And they're after the puck. Henrik knocked it into the corner for Kessler. It bounced off the sticks of Kessler and Campbell out of play.
Well, if ever you're going to get yourself into the Stanley Cup Final offensively, now's the time. It's the power play that this tandem has feasted on all year long. They were the best power play during the regular season, one of the best going in to the Stanley Cup Finals, but it just has not been in sync. And you see Henrik there is shaking his leg a little bit, much like the leg injury he had in Nashville. We got to watch him here after it looked like he tweaked it in game 3.
Kessler and Kelly facing off, and now Kessler's waved up. Henrik's had a tough time, 35% of his faceoffs in the Stanley Cup Final, and he lost that draw to Kelly. Daniel Kessler go after the puck. They're bumped. The puck comes back to Edner. He shoots just wide of the net. Bouncing puck. Chara cleared it on the boards. Not out. Ehrhoff held it in. It was over and back at the blue line. This is a delayed offside call. And the whistle is finally blown.
You're always under the microscope when you're a top player. And Henrik Sedin in the Nashville series, as I said, he had a little bit of a leg problem. There he gets a little slash in the back of the leg by Seidenberg. And he definitely looks to be limping. Here was game 3, battling for the puck. It was Seidenberg again. Gave him a hack and then a little shot down. And he came up a little bit lame there. And we'll watch his progress here in this game.
Lots of ice bags, lots of band-aids. At game 4 of the Stanley Cup Final. Daniel Sedin lined up against the boards on the left wing, took the pass, but the Canucks have to regroup with their man advantage. group. Now they start up ice. They're off with the shooting. On the fly is Kessler. Chara got there first. And a puck is cleared around the boards. Again, it stays in off the stanchion. Ehrhoff on the other side. Edler's shot. Nice save by Thomas there. Brad Marchand trying to clear the puck. Edler knocked it down. He's up against Bergeron, trying to hold it in, and does. Ryan Kessler for Daniel Sedin out of his reach. In comes Ehrhoff. Holds the puck in for Henrik. Daniels alone in front, and Henrik couldn't get him the puck. Seidenberg stepped in. Sedin's double-team Seidenberg here. Kessler comes in to help as well. Great work though by Bergeron. Couldn't get by Kessler. Centering pass went off a skate. In comes Alex Edler. Daniels in front of the net. Henrik patiently back to Edler. He's got Ehrhoff on the other side. The pass goes into Henrik. Kessler's gone to the front of the net. Edler's in the slot as well. Henrik slap pass tipped wide by Alex Edler. And high two out of play with 14 seconds left in the Ryder penalty.
Wow, it is nasty in front of the net, guys. And there's some culprits we have seen many a time in the pictures here. There's a slash by Daniel. Down goes Char, and then in front of the net, it's an absolute nightmare. Seidenberg with a chop there. Kessler gives him a hit. Couple more cross checks. Kessler's actually the more aggressive one. Tough place to stand in the Stanley Cup Final, but it's a place you're going to score from.
And Glenn, you're going to keep doing that until a penalty's called. I mean, the way that they've been able to battle there, it's carte blanche now. Until the officials call and put an end to it, those kind of battles are going to continue.
Second power play unit will get the last 14 seconds for Vancouver of this power play. Andrew Ferentz to Johnny Boychuk. And Rich Peverly, and Boston will get out into the neutral zone. Chris Kelly. Ferentz is up on the rush. Ryder's penalty has expired, and it's 5-on-5 again. Vancouver's 0-for-1 on the power play, and 1-for-17 in the series. Just one shot on that power play, although they had some pressure. The Exodus center, Johnny Boychuk, stops the puck and shoots it back in. Ballard just about gave the puck away. Now he has Krejci in front. Lucic can't make it settle down. David Krejci, Adam McQuaid shot. That was blocked. All of this because Ballard got in some big trouble and gave the puck away, but a bouncing puck kept anybody from getting a good chance. Here's Krejci, centering, Ryder, stop. Great sliding block, another shot. Ballard made the first block. Luongo gets the second one, and the play is finally stopped.
Well, when you make a mistake, you do everything to rectify it, and Ballard draws the challenge, as we said early, Jim, of coming into the lineup, but also having to play against the top players. And he turns the puck over, a good chance early on, and the end result was once again Ballard coming across, Krejci behind the net, three Vancouver Canucks below the line, nobody out in front, where Ryder had a chance, an excellent slide block by Ballard there.
Was he ever wide open? Rick Bonus, who handles the defense, talking to the defenseman. Daberle floats one in. That was deflected wide of the net. Boston's going to come on here since killing the penalty. Daberle again against Oreskovich, trying to hold the puck in. Sammy Salo. The Manny Malhotra couldn't get the puck out. Held in by Kelly. Andrew Albert's up the boards. Oreskovich can't get it out against a pinching Thomas Daberle. Here's a pass that comes to Adam McQuaid. Daberle into the side of the net. Salo intercepts that pass, slows things down, and gets Vancouver out of its own zone. Look at the hairy minutes there for Vancouver. Tanner Glass in forechecking. Tyler Seguin back to help out. Kick the puck loose, and Daberle starts out for Boston. Chris Kelly at center. He wants to change, but he gets the puck deep.
Jim, you mentioned the ice being so bad, and you know it's only going to get worse. It makes that first goal and getting the lead that much more important. So difficult to try to come from behind when the ice is chippy and the puck's bouncing all over.
Long pass tipped in by Mason Raymond in Vancouver into forecheck again. Recky is back helping out the defense. Look where Christian Ehrhoff is, pinching in deep, and now he's in trouble. Here comes Marchand. Raymond's getting back. It's one-on-one, and the weak shot goes wide as Marchand couldn't dance Alex Edler. Back the other way come the Canucks. Three of them. Here's Higgins into the middle. Christian Ehrhoff shoots. Thomas the save. Made an easy one. And the rebound is cleared to center. Patrice Bergeron back. Marchand heads for the net. Recky's coming up late, but the puck was tipped by Christian Ehrhoff. And Higgins settles things down.
Both players were exhausted, Jim. Recky exhausted on the offense. Ehrhoff out of breath as well.
And Tim Thomas stops the puck in front of Alex Burrows and covers up for a faceoff. 4-3 of the shots in favor of Vancouver. Tim Thomas looks great again on Hockey Night in Canada at the Stanley Cup Final.
MVP of each game. After game seven, the winner was our Subway restaurant bio subject, Nathan Horton. And when the Bruins won game three, the players decided to leave it in his stall, dedicate the victory to him. Horton is out for the rest of the series. Peter Chiarelli said an hour before game time last he heard, he was resting comfortably at home. Jim?
Henrik Sedin just won the faceoff. Edler with his shot that didn't get to the net. Sedin's had a great shift their last time out, and they started that one well. Now they're after the puck again. Krejci trying to clear it. Here's Bergeron. Two centers on the ice for the faceoff, and Bergeron turned the puck over in the neutral zone. Henrik dumps it in. Quick shift for the Sedin, and a change on the fly. Chara to David Krejci at center. Ahead for Rich Peverly. He's in alone. Scores! For Nathan Horton, Rich Peverly makes it 1-0 Boston.
And little mistakes, a rolling puck, Edler holds his ground instead of backing off, and Peverly makes him pay. A little chip pass and a bouncing puck, a chip right there by Krejci. And for Roberto Luongo, he went down early, didn't have the stick between the five hole. I think at the last second he thought Peverly was maybe going to deke him, and he found space. Edler was minus four in game three and a tough start here in game four.
Peverly from Krejci and Chara. What a pickup Rich Peverly has been. Such a versatile guy. He can play center on your fourth line. He can kill penalties. He can play in the power play. And now he's playing on the top line, and he gets the big first goal of the game. Vancouver trying to strike back with their third line on the ice. Yannick Hansen's after the puck. Pinching in is Andrew Alberts against Sean Thornton. Thornton lugs the puck to center. Didn't make a play, put a teammate offside. Paye. And now some pushing and shoving of the bench as the puck is shot in.
You saw that puck bouncing behind the Boston net. I mean, there's a great example of just as the period goes, the ice level deteriorates.
Here's Daniel Seen with his shot. Had some speed as he got in after the puck. Kevin Bieksa wires one, and Thomas way out makes the save as he bumped into Daniel Sedin. Up the boards, Bieksa ever aggressive, holding the puck in with a pinch. Daniel Sedin for Henrik. Seidenberg steps in. Henrik gets physical. Daniel looking for Alex Burrows in front. He knocked the puck out of the air. Henrik, Seidenberg's all over him. Another good cycle shift here for the Sedins. Keith Ballard from the blue line. His wrist shot deflected. Thomas has it. Didn't know it. Looked behind him and got the whistle. And again, bodies all over and around the crease.
It's the aggressiveness of Thomas, though, that Vancouver has to take advantage of. Look how far out of the blue paint he is. So anything with a little chip to the side of the net, that's a 6-by-4. Vancouver defense are very active. They're allowed to pinch, they're allowed to jump up in the play, but you have to be so careful and make sure that you've got your forwards backing you up. Ralphie Torres was flat-footed, he had no chance. Here's another example, very aggressive. Albert jumps in on the pinch and given that green light. But when you jump in, you've got to make sure you got support, otherwise you'll give up a breakaway and a goal like they do with Peverly.
A couple of good shifts in response for Vancouver after the goal. One by their third line, and then from their first, and now it's the Kessler line taking over. Kessler won the draw. Salo's shot deflected just wide of the net. And again, there was lots of room behind Thomas. Edler pinching down, couldn't get the puck. Lucic cut off at the pass by Salo. And back to the puck is Chris Higgins. Mason Raymond already up at the blue line on the right side. Sammy Salo bobbled the puck as he looked up. Alex Edler, his pass hits Kessler on the fly up against Ferris. Mason Raymond follows and takes the drop pass. Tried to get away from that hit but fell down. And this will be a chance for the Bruins to break up. Three on two at center. David Krejci. Lucic heads for the net. Peverly comes up late. All he can do is tip that puck into the corner. Christian Erhoff stepped in front of David Krejci. He's grabbing him, tosses him down. Edler comes over for the puck. And Mason Raymond put it off the boards and out for Vancouver. Thomas Kaberle. Regrouping for Boston. Both teams have changed on the fly. Tyler Seguin with some speed into the attacking zone up against Alberts. His centering pass for Ryder was deflected by Christian Erhoff. Oreskovic lost the puck in his feet. Now he's got it. Kicks it up again. Around for Tanner Glass. Pinching his Boychuk. Kept the puck in. And again it was bouncing as Ryder couldn't control it. Albert's outlet knocked down by Chris Kelly. Play back to Andrew Ferentz. Up on the right wing, Seguin at the end of a shift just tips the puck in. Vancouver's got some time here. Boston has changed. Sedin lines back on a long shot by Erhoff. Thomas to Seidenberg. Henrik Sedin won't let the puck out. In behind the net, Seidenberg had it bounce on him. In comes Ballard off the defense. Puck's held in. Henrik. Alex Burrows can't shoot it. Now he takes the shot. Thomas the save. Henrik and the rebound. That's stopped by Thomas. Might have hit the side of the net. Sliding to try and get the puck is Burrows, and he can't. Patrice Bergeron with his shooting. Marchand goes after the puck, and he tipped up Bieksa. And another penalty coming up here. Goaltender's leading for the extra attacker. Here comes Keith Ballard with his shot. Rebound. Alex Burrows throws the puck in front. Torres with his shot. Blocked. Thrown back to the blue line. And this will go all the way back into the Vancouver end with the net empty. And Bieksa's back to get the puck. Great chance to score the delayed penalty call. And it's still a delayed penalty call. And finally the whistle goes. And the penalty will be called to Brad Marchand, who's on the bench. Yeah, he's got to serve some time. Even though he's over at the bench right now, it's a cross-check push. Bieksa goes down, Marchand gets the penalty, and the fans and the coach don't like that.
You get warned by the official. When you're a rookie, you end up getting a call like that. That happens later.
Claude Julien had a talk with him, said, you got to be a player. Enough of the funny stuff. Play.
Vancouver won the draw. Christian Erhoff. Alexander Edler skates in, took a shot, blocked by Seidenberg. Edler got it back. Trying to set. And the puck's taken away. Gregory Campbell cleared it, and the penalty killers are going to take this opportunity to change up. Daniel Sedin plays the puck back to Christian Erhoff. First couple of power plays, Alex Edler's been very aggressive up into the slot. Daniel Sedin dropped the puck off to Ryan Kessler. On the other side, Christian Erhoff. Edler in the middle of the ice, side of the net. Kessler, one-timer went in behind the goal. It was partially blocked. Henrik Sedin pinned to the boards. Chara takes the puck and takes off. It's the center and dumps it in.
40-second power play. They weren't really able to establish the setup and get the shot they wanted. Now that second unit comes out for some offense.
Adler with the shoot-in. Took a crazy bounce at the back of the net. Boychuk hammers the puck up the boards, and he got it by Salo and all the way down the ice.
Well, right now, too, the Boston penalty kill has so much confidence. I mean, they take chances. They're very aggressive. They come at you and try to outman you, even though they're shorthanded.
And Boychuk taking a chance, and he knocked Higgins off the puck, and it's cleared. Luongo out to play it. Kevin Bieksa. Chris Higgins plays the puck back. Sammy Salo will carry it up the ice. Burrows, Raymond, Higgins in front of it. Kevin Bieksa advanced the puck, and it's an offside call with 33 seconds left in the Marchand penalty.
Pretty clear that the Boston Bruins do not like the Sedins, and any chance they can throw a little lumber, maybe Greg Campbell grabs him by the throat, and just keep him on the ice. The linesman's got to come over and separate them. You know, after that big hit with Horton, and at the end of the first period, it was Chara, who rarely says anything, stood up in the locker room and went at it for about 8 minutes, letting his team know that this is unacceptable. We have to win the game. And boy, did they win that game in a big way. So when you wake the big guy up, you're in trouble, and they have awoken Chara.
Poke the bear. Alex Edler leads his power play to center. Shoot in by Erhoff. The Sedin's back out there. Chara finds some space up the middle. Edler knocked the puck down. Paye's right there. Not sure that Edler saw it. Dan Paye, and a bouncing puck heads to the corner, and that's a recurring theme tonight. And this is just early in the game. It's hot in the building. It's hot outside. Ehrhoff with a long shot in on Tim Thomas. Shots are 10-4 Vancouver, but the Bruins lead the game 1-0 on the goal by Rich Peverly. Here comes Lucic with a shot and a nice glove save by Roberto Luongo.
Tim Thomas has been spectacular, guys. Home shutout streak of 172 minutes that got beat last game by the one goal that Vancouver Canucks scored on him. But he's showing you why he's maybe this year's Vezina and last year's Vezina. He's just a very aggressive guy. And Luongo, he's trying to match him 200 feet away. You talk about the ice, guys. Normally they keep it at 26 degrees. It's been 20 degrees all day at ice level. And if it's below 20, it chips and it gets cracked. Well, they're trying to hope that keeping it at 20 gives at least these guys a canvas to play on.
Maxime Lapierre has McClain on the tough side of the puck. There's a backhander by Manny Malhotra. Tim Thomas is down, and he makes a tough goal line stand.
If ever there's a great example of the battle in Tim Thomas, that's it. An excellent play by Lapierre. You get the outside angle, take it hard to the net, but watch Thomas fight for this puck. The rebound's there for a split second. Daniel's trying to poke it home, and that left leg just anchors itself, and then Thomas, through that crowd, somehow gets the glove on the puck.
It's the same story as game number three. Tim Thomas with a 1-0 lead, making exceptional saves. Vancouver's had the puck a lot more than Boston, especially since that goal. Had a couple of power plays, failed on both. David Krejci to Milan Lucic. He stops up, feeds across ice, intercepted. Vancouver takes off. Ehrhoff jumped up. He had a pass ahead, Lapierre couldn't get it.
1 minute remaining in the period.
There's Michael Ryder. Lucic back to Ryder. Gains the line. Krejci's right behind him. Ryder gets open and shoots. That hit the post and came out. That looked like it was right behind Luongo and almost in. Sammy Salo feeds the puck to center.
There's that mix match for Claude Julien. He puts Ryder up there this time instead of Peverly. And boy, Ryder looked pretty confident there, didn't he? Inside, outside. Good short side high shot just about beat him.
Shoot in by Kevin Bieksa. Johnny Boychuk is back. Zdeno Chara to Brad Marchand. Checked by Viktor Oreskovich. And Boychuk will try and come out the other side. Mark Recchi up against Alex Hedlund. Tanner Glass at center. Over to hit Marchand was Kevin Bieksa. In the last 10 seconds of the first period, Zdeno Chara has a look at the clock. Decides to waste one in Luongo, knocks it down, and the Boston Bruins will take a 1-0 lead into the first intermission. A goal by Rich Peverly at 11:59 from Krejci and Chara, and Tim Thomas stopped 12. Here's Ryder's chance again. Saw a little daylight, and he hit the post. That would have been huge. 2-0 lead in the late going. Instead, it's 1-0 for Boston as they head to the dressing room after a busy first period. Don Cherry, Ron McLean, Coach's Corner. Up next on Hockey Night in Canada at the Stanley Cup Final.
For the second period, it's Canadian Celebrity Night here. Rachel McAdams in the building watching the Canucks and Bruins. And if you go to text the number 20222 and type in the word Nash, you will donate $10 to the Steve Nash Foundation and have the chance to win a pint with Steve Nash in New York City. And Steve, you're a big Canucks fan. They're struggling a bit right now. You've been in this position. What would you say?
They just got to keep their composure. You know, we're a passing team. Boston's out passing us. I think we're a little bit rattled. We just need to keep our composure and keep getting shots on net. Everything seems to hit Thomas in the chest right now, but we'll get a bounce here and it'll break us wide open.
Your brother-in-law, Manny Malhotra, it must be so special for the family to see him back playing.
Unbelievable. You know, he's one of the classiest guys I've ever met. You couldn't want your sister to marry anyone greater than Manny, and to see what he's been able to handle and come back and play well, I admire him a lot.
All right, thanks very much, Steve. Enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you.
Jim?
There's Steve's team trying to get to the attack, led by Ryan Kessler, Mason Raymond, and Chris Higgins to start this second period. Trailing 1-0 on the former Kitchener Dutchman Junior B, Rich Peverly's goal. Bieksa in deep. Now that's Mason Raymond back defensively, and he knocked the puck away from Brad Marchand. Mark Recchi and Marchand. Another good move by Marchand, and the puck bounced on him. Here's Chris Higgins. Kevin Bieksa, breakaway pass, tipped through by Cherup from Kessler, who takes the sharp angled shot, and Thomas handles that easily as Kessler gets a rough ride from Seidenberg.
Yeah, that's a line for the Vancouver Canucks that needs to continue putting pressure and getting their offense going. If the Sedin line is going like they have been in the first period, they need that secondary push. And Ryan Kessler, you think of what he did in the Nashville series, 11 of the 14 goals he was involved in. Right now, they need that line to be a little bit more effective.
That line hasn't scored yet in this series. This line's been excellent. Henrik and Daniel Sedin, Alex Burrows had a very good first period. Shinano Chara out against them again. Here's Milan Lucic from David Krejci. Plays broken up by Sammy Salo. Salo and Edler playing against this Krejci line. Here comes Rich Peverly. The shot broke the stick of Alex Edler. That's a story we saw in game number three. Edler got in trouble without a stick. This time the puck gets to center. Edler can't get to the bench to get a new stick. Burrows gives in his. Pass towards the front of the net. Edler blocked that. Krejci's knocked down, and Edler with Alex Burrows' stick breaks out and takes a long shot. And as Seidenberg is back, Chara fed the puck up the boards on a Vancouver chain. David Krejci dropped past Lucic with a shot, hit a leg. In comes Dennis Seidenberg. Side of the net, Krejci can't handle a bouncing puck. Albert's moved it ahead. Tanner Glass got the puck out to center. Rappi Torres, excuse me, he's out with Lapierre and Yannick Hansen. Crashing in Sean Thornton for Boston. Caverly holds the puck into the line. Nice job of Ehrhoff stepping in, getting the puck to center. Yannick Hansen on his own. Torres coming up to join him. Pass off the board. Torres hooked it in front out of the reach of Lapierre. The other way comes Sean Thornton. He's got some speed in on Ballard. Try to fake a pass, and Ballard blocked that. Puck sent back towards the point. Caberlet holds it in. Kaye tried to tip it out front, couldn't. Thornton, hard centering pass. Gregory Campbell tipped it, and Luongo steered to the side. And the discarded broken stick of Edler's is getting in the way. Yannick Hansen up against Chara. Couldn't get the puck out. Tipped by Ehrhoff, and now the Canucks will get out. Daniel Sedin's just come on. He's fresh. Hansen drops in behind him. Daniel's shot is blocked. Vancouver's changing. Paille late in his shift. He chips the puck in and heads for the bench as well. Bergeron up against Henrik Sedin, who made the play along the boards, and Alex Burrows starts out for Vancouver. Dropped it back. Bieksa had to turn back, and he got hit by Bergeron. Seidenberg held the puck in. Ballard couldn't get it out. Now he makes a pass up the middle. Burrows to Henrik Sedin and then to Kevin Bieksa. Back to Alex Burrows with Daniel Sedin. He shoots, deflected, and stopped by Thomas. Chris Kelly trying to get out of his own zone, and he does with a pass to Marchand. In on Kevin Bieksa. Kent Hansen can't make the pass to the front of the net. Henrik Sedin put the puck around the boards, and Adam McQuaid held it in for Boston. In comes Caberle off the blue line, backed up there by Chris Kelly. His slap pass into Caberle. The defenseman checked by Alex Burrows. Caberle holds the puck in with a shot, deflected off a hand and wide. Brad Marchand centering pass, that's deflected. McQuaid with a shot wide of the net. Marchand trying to bank one in, and Luongo got across. Caberle against the tired line, shoots. Deflected wide. Marchand in front for Kelly. That's tipped off the glass and out over the blue line. Henrik Sedin and Alex Burrows. Daniel Sedin can't get off. Pinned in their own zone. Daniel's been able to change. That's it. Great shift for the Bruins. Leading 1-0. One of the best shifts for Thomas Caberle of this series. Here's Chris Kelly for Tyler Seguin. Bruins on the attack. Here is Ferentz, plays the puck across. Boychuk shot intentionally wide. Puck bounces along the boards. Tanner Glass with Manny Milholtz trying to get it out. Alex Edler with his own stick moves the puck ahead. Here's Viktor Oreskovich. Glass tries the net. Thomas stops the puck and he hangs on.
Second periods have not been good for Alexander Edler. Hey, it's great for Easton because his stick breaks every time the second period starts. You remember Game 3, stick broke at the start of the second period. And Andrew Ferentz is the recipient.
Whoa!
I think it's time to get a stick with a little bit more of a flex, because obviously you're a big guy and it doesn't take much for you to break them. That was a long shift for Edler and Bieksa. Edler spent part of it with Burrow stick and part of it with a new twig.
That was a tough shift for Vancouver, pinned in their own end for that whole shift. Ryan Kessler to take the draw. He and the Canucks won 62% of the faceoffs in the first. Krejci had a tough time in the first, but he won that one. Lucic trying to break out, turned the puck over, and it's Kempe. Ferentz to Krejci, and now Boston is out. Herzer on the right, second center out here, takes the shot, the wall goes steered to the side. Andrew Ferentz in off the blue line, around the boards, Ballard goes after the puck, so does Boychuk come in. Ballard can't get by Lucic. Kessler backing up Ballard, again he can't get the puck out. David Krejci into the middle, Ferentz with a shot that's blocked. Backhand is sent to the corner. Again, the Bruins put on the pressure. Peverly to the blue line, Ferentz screenshot, blocked by Keith Ballard. And he finally gets the puck out, but that was a tough shift for Ballard. Kessler driving up the middle. Goes after the puck, shot in by Higgins.
Notice the fact that Ballard's out with Salo there. It, obviously, Alain Vigneault wasn't too happy with that first period with Ballard having to go up against the top lines. He ended up having to do it there with Salo. Made another mistake.
And the Canucks are really starting to miss Dan Hamhuis. Ehrhoff shoots the puck in deep. McQuaid is back. Hard around the boards. Ehrhoff trying to hold the puck in. Couldn't quite do it. Caberlet. Advanced the puck. Gregory Campbell had it out of his reach. And the play is just offside. 6 minutes into this second period.
Well, it's a tough task to come in the Stanley Cup Finals. You haven't been playing all the time. And, you know, when mistakes happen, you have to recover. Ballard did it in the first period by blocking the shot. He does it here again. And there was some thought, Jim, that going into game four in the San Jose series, Tanev and Ballard played together, and that matchup did extremely well. But as you mentioned, without Hamhuis, it really changes the dynamics, doesn't it, of the defensive pairing.
The depth is really tested, and Hamhuis is off their top pair.
You could afford to have Tanev in the lineup there with Ballard because you had that strong two.
Turn over, and Rafi Torres with his shot that Thomas steered aside. Torres gets a hit. McQuaid couldn't get the puck. He's backed up. John Thornton, the center, painted himself into a corner and dumped the puck in. Paye in after Edler. Made the play. Torres couldn't get the puck out. Bounced on him, and Seidenberg holds it in. Gregory Campbell knocked off the puck by Kevin Bieksa. Made a play up the boards. Yannick Hansen into the middle. Puck skipped away from Lapierre. Torres takes the shot. Tipped right on, and Thomas made the save. Torres again with a shot. And another great save by Tim Thomas, who's been terrific again. Shots are 19-7 Vancouver, but the score is 1-0 Boston on Hockey Night in Canada.
Look, wraps at Rachel McAdam. Go to cbcsports.ca to pick your angle. Clearly, Dan Hamhuis suffered a significant injury when he sent 220-pound Milan Lucic airborne in game one. He was watching this morning, not skating. The Canucks' official designation with the playoff nuclear triple cone of silence in effect is Hamhuis' day-to-day, but it's not logical to speculate on his return until he at least skates again. And, Jim, because he hasn't, the speculation's going in the opposite direction that he could be done for the rest of the final.
There's Bieksa right off the draw. Loose puck. Henrik and Daniel Sedin swarm it. Alex Burrow's there as well, and the Bruins kept it away from their net. The Sedins have been dangerous on every shift tonight. Daniel just got away with a trip on Patrice Bergeron that was detected by 10,000 of the 17 grand in the crowd. Bieksa shoveled the puck. Ricky took a shot at the net. Here's Alex Burrow. Out to center, Chara stepped in front of Henrik Sedin. Patrice Bergeron fights the puck over the blue line and the play's offside.
Jim, right now it just seems like the Canucks are going to have to get lucky to burst the bubble. And right now, when you win a draw, this line has done so many effective things off of the faceoff. Three bodies there. Daniel goes behind the net, though, instead of in front. Had he stopped in front of the net, he might have been on the doorstep and had an easy tap in there. Isn't that the way it goes? Thomas seems to have all the answers right now. Even in the scrambles, he's finding the puck.
Shots in this period are 8-1 in favor of Vancouver, although Boston's had a couple of shifts where they've had Vancouver hemmed in. They just didn't get any shots.
This is one of those
scary games where you're playing a good road game, all the stats are looking your way, but you look up and you're down by one.
And with Thomas, never know, that might be enough. Barron's hooked at by Mason Raymond. Both arms are in the air, and Boston's going to get its first power play. Here's Milan Lucic. He shoots, Longo makes the save, and the penalty be called. Mason Raymond will go off, and the Boston power play works for the first time tonight.
Well, you're just trying to create something. You get in on the forecheck, your stick, your bad puck rolling, and the errant stick goes up the stick, and Ferentz puts his hand up and gets the call.
And, you know, you look at the last play, guys. This is how close the Canucks were to taking a penalty there. Slash on Marchand, then Daniel Sedin with a chip. But, guys, let's take a look at this penalty. It doesn't even hit him in the face. And he sells the call. There goes the head back, and that's, you know, one of the things that they talked about before this series, the integrity of the game, and you can't sell calls. Well, it just didn't. They bought.
Could have been a hooking penalty, too. Should have had a stick there. Here's Seidenberg. Caberle on the power play. Krejci shoots. Luongo makes the save. Rebound. Bergeron tried to center it. Couldn't do it. Andrew Alberts killing the penalty. Gets the puck down the ice. Power play features Caberle and Seidenberg. Lucic, Bergeron, Krejci up front. David Krejci dangling towards the net. Alberts stopped him. The puck comes loose to Luongo.
This is where Luongo can really make a statement. He's played well coming off of the 8-1 loss in game three. Things got away from him in that third period, second period and third in game three. But right now, he hasn't been busy, but he's been sharp when he has to be. And three times this year, there's been some big lopsided scores. He's lost the two other ones. What will happen today?
Zdeno Chara out of the power play with Andrew Ferentz on the point now. Here's Michael Ryder. Cross to Chara, one-timer, that's blocked in front. Mark Recchi with Rich Peverly in front, the pass to the blue line, and not even the reach of Chara could come up with that puck. Manny Malhotra, 7 minutes in his first game, 15 in his second, playing a lot again tonight, killing penalties. He goes off for Ryan Kessler. Chara shoots the puck in, Recchi's after it. Peverly tracks it down. Michael Ryder there as well, but the Canucks aggressively come up with it. Burrow's got the puck to center, he's got Kessler with him. Now they're on the attack, shorthanded the shot. Thomas has to stop play. And Burrows turns away and doesn't get mixed up with Chara after the whistle.
Malhotra back in the lineup, and he's a great faceoff guy. And penalty killer gives him a fourth line. But watch the communication here. As there's a chance to beat Chara to the puck, he points to the bench. And what he says is, I'm going to change in a second. I'm coming to the bench. I'm coming. And sure enough, as soon as he knows he can't get the puck, well, he goes to the bench. And there's another sold call. Some point, they got to put an end to it.
LaPierre won the draw, shorthanded in the attacking zone. That kills some valuable seconds. Caberle and Seidenberg back out. Lucic up front with Bergeron and Krejci. Bergeron to the net, tipped wide by Lucic, who's tied up by Ballard. Gets himself loose. Bergeron with a shot just wide of the net. In too tight. Here's Caberle with some room from the blue line. LaPierre taking his shot away. Stays with him. Dennis Seidenberg's got a bomb, won't shoot it right now. Milan Lucic. In comes Caberle, the shot off the shoulder of Luongo and out of play. 14 seconds to go in the Raymond penalty.
Well, it's amazing how things can change within a series. The Boston Bruins power play was anemic coming into the Stanley Cup final. Somehow they were able to make it at just 8.2%, five goals in 67, but like so many times, it's what you do in the finals under the pressure, and they've executed the last two games extremely well. And they look dangerous again here in game four.
Now Holtra on to win the draw. Edler battling against Kelly. And the Canucks win the battle, get the puck down the ice, and that'll do it in the Mason Raymond penalty. So the penalty killers are perfect tonight, both sides. Raymond's back on, 5-on-5 again. Salo whacked the puck across the ice. Yannick Hansen got away, plays offside. Close call. I don't think Hansen believes it.
We've seen the bouncing pucks. We've talked a lot about the ice conditions. That one actually works in favor of Hansen. But is that offside? Tough to call there. I thought he was able to keep that foot down.
I
I would agree with you, Simmer. That's, yeah. That's an onside play that they've taken a breakaway with. Linesman Shearer was 85 feet away to make the call. You saw Miller make a great call in game one, right on the line. But that one there is a missed call.
Brad Marchand battling here with Henrik Sedin. Bergeron kicks the puck back, Zdeno Chara loads up, fires, stopped by Luongo. And Henrik Sedin gets a rough ride again in front of the net, and again hovering over him is Brad Marchand. Mark Recchi pleading the case here to keep Brad Marchand in the game, and he's going to stay in it for now as he battles with Henrik Sedin. He got his stick in his face. He pitchforked him down. No penalty calls.
So much at stake, Craig. What are the players like on the ice right now in a 1-0 game?
Well, you're anxious a little bit. I think the anxiety grows as the series continues on. But much like Steve Nash said, you just got to keep your composure and keep forging ahead. This has been a good road game by Vancouver, but they just haven't been able to get that break that can break them out of it.
Trying to keep at it here with Ryan Kessler's line on the ice. Daniel Paille played the puck back. Johnny Boychuk, D-to-D with Ferentz. And Gregory Campbell off the glass and safely out. Paille's racing for the puck. Kevin Bieksa got over first. Here comes Thornton, though. Gets control, got a shot blocked by Bieksa and pounced on by Roberto Luongo.
Once again, a fourth line shift that just creates some momentum for Boston. And that's all you're looking for. Come in with energy, keep the puck going forward, don't get hemmed into your own end. And that Boston line with Thornton in the lineup now is able to continue doing that.
Manny Malhotra on to take this faceoff against Chris Kelly. Malhotra got the draw with some persistence. Sammy Salo up the boards. Tanner Glass on Vancouver's fourth line advances the puck. McQuaid is back. Malhotra's right on him. Forces him to make a play. Reading that was Oreskovich. He got over there, but he couldn't stop the puck. Now he battles Ryder and Kaberlin. Canucks get it. Salo to the open side. Alberts has to respect that Sagan is there, and he backs off. Ryder Sagan to Michael Ryder. Moves in and shoots. He scores! The post trying to go high glove in the first. Didn't miss in the second. 2-0 Boston.
Well, and he beat Roberto Luongo in game three for the eighth goal. An absolute rocket of a wrister. And so his confidence level with that shot keeps it to the outside, drags it back, and gets through on Sammy Salo. Does Salo get a piece of it? Well, he's not a good active enough stick. Maybe a little bit of a knuckler off the stick of Salo. If you're going to get your stick in there, you got to be more aggressive and try to take it away. And Luongo, deep in his net there, gets beat under the glove.
There's a tip right on Thomas. And Paille out to center. TD Garden buzzing now. The Bruins have a 2-0 lead. That's a big lead for Tim Thomas, the way he's played at home and in this series. Is seventh from Sagan and Kelly.
And Jim, there's where you do have to keep your composure. Just get a little pushback shift. Don't lose the game in a 2 or 3 minute span. Don't allow Boston to get another quick one and seize all the momentum.
Icing call against Vancouver.
It's all about detail, though, guys. In Vancouver, they get caught making a bad change. Go to the bench. That's not the time to change. Sagan's got the puck. You're changing there? I don't think so. Sagan was put in the lineup because of that offensive flair and flash and because of the speed, and he pays dividends in his first game in with Horton out.
What do you think? Did that go off, Sammy?
I think it got a piece of it, but it's one that, Glenn, you'd know better. The vision was there for Luongo. It was far enough out, and it just fooled him.
His body language to me, Luongo's, told me that he thought it went off himself.
Yeah. David Krejci to Lucic. And over in the corner, we've got penalties being called, maybe both of them. Alberts is going to go.
And Peverly.
And Rich Peverly, too.
A little battle off of the faceoff, which we haven't seen too many calls off of the interference off the draw, but Alberts and Peverly go hard after each other. So some four-on-four hockey here with 7:55 to go, and now a two-goal lead by Boston. Watch down low, a slash to the back of the legs by Peverly, and then a slash back by Alberts, and the official caught them both.
Officially a slash and a cross check. Peverly gets the cross check.
You
take your pick, though.
Four-on-four hockey is to the benefit of the Vancouver Canucks. More ice for the Sedins.
They've been good tonight, but have nothing to show for it. David Krejci won the draw. He's been good, too. Gennaro Chara put the puck in. Kennedy exit, cut it off, and out he started. Got the Sedins with him. Daniel takes over. Lucci chasing him, pushed him down, took the puck and moves it ahead. This spring has really been a coming-out party for David Krejci, this gifted center who's had to move up because of injury to Savard. And the play is stopped here with a minute 43 to go, and the penalties to Alberts and Peverly.
No one's getting any respect if you're wearing a white sweater in this building. Sedin's getting it every way. And how about Alberts when he goes to the box for his penalty? He can't get into the box. They've got the door shut. Like, okay, I took a penalty. Stop writing. Would you let me in?
And they're doing his homework.
No one's giving him any respect in the building. Even the timekeepers.
Christian Ehrhoff starts Vancouver out of its own end. One on three, turnover. Kelly's racing after the puck. Salo's got a stride on it. Throws it up the middle. Ferentz shielding the puck from Ryan Kessler. Puck skipped on Kelly. Ehrhoff is back, flushed out quickly by Michael Ryder. Alex Burrows with Ryan Kessler. They crisscross a second time. Too much traffic there for Burrows. One on three, turned the puck over. Now he changes. Daniel and Henrik Sedin come back on. Michael Ryder coast to coast, can't get the shot away. And he needs to change. Turnover, Chara runs into Bieksa, slows him up, and Ballard gets the puck. Henrik Sedin's outlet. Chara reaches to hold the puck in. In for Brad Marchand. Ballard turns away from him. He's tripped up, and comes Bergeron. Henrik got the puck away from him, lost it in the feet of Ballard. Backhand shot, Marchand scores! Marchand, 3-0 Boston.
Jim, it's hard to pick on a guy who's playing maybe above where he should be right now in the lineup, but for Keith Ballard, this has been a bad start to a night that's gotten worse. He got caught on the inside there, gets the puck, now turns it over. Up the boards, and it's back the other way. But when you get knocked over, he loses the puck here. You're not going to draw a penalty. Get up. This is Stanley Cup Finals. Get to the front of the net. Puck's in his feet. And Brad Marchand has been a thorn in the side of the Sedins all night long. Standing in front. Nobody's there. And the quick backhander up and over Luongo. But for Ballard, that's a shift that just dug a hole. And he couldn't get out of it.
Two goals in 2 minutes and 18 seconds, and Vancouver's Alain Vigneault took his 32nd timeout to talk to his team.
That's what I was meaning there. You can lose a game in a short period of time by just lapse of energy, lapse of judgment, and errors right now are the downfall of Vancouver.
Well, you need to save. You've given up 13 shots. You guys had mentioned it. It's a pretty good road game. You need to save. The other guy's making them 200 feet away.
Marchand from Bergeron. Here's Elliott.
Well, Brad Marchand is the guy, Jim, who the Boston Bruins felt was too far out of control and over the line after the first two games in Vancouver. Periodically, he'll get a talking to from Claude Julien about it. He got it, and it's worked, Jim.
Boston goal score.
He's been great back here in Boston. That goal was 4-on-4. And that continues right now. Daniel Sedin, hard shot towards the net. Ehrhoff got drilled by Seidenberg as he tried to get the puck. Gennaro Chara needs the puck for Gregory Campbell. It's out of his reach. Alex Ebner is back, and that's an icing call against Boston.
Jim, here's where if you're not playing well and you're not scoring goals, you've got to find a way, if you're a Vancouver Canuck player, to make a difference physically. And what Ehrhoff does, he's not known to take in the body. He tries to get in, get involved, but we saw it in game three. The energy turned in the second period. The Boston Bruins got life, they got focus, and they got hitting. And Seidenberg, not known for his big hits either, knocks him down.
It's a solid guy, though. Over to Alberts and Rich Peverly, 5-on-5 again. Peverly lost his stick. Kessler takes the puck, ran into Chara as he dumped it in. Seidenberg back. There's Zdeno Chara. The Bruin captain got the puck to center. Paille tipped it in and heads for the bench on a change. And this sold out, jacked up crowd is really giving it to Roberto Luongo right now.
You have to wonder if it might have been worse if that was at the Rogers Arena.
Caberle checked and knocked down. Now the Bruins made the play, got the puck out. Keith Ballard. His pass tipped in by Yannick Hansen. Adam McQuaid looks around, first man back. Couldn't get the puck by Rafi Torres, but he knocked it out of the air with a high stick, and play is stopped with under 5 minutes to go in the second period. Michael Ryder scored his seventh of the playoffs, beat Luongo 2 minutes and 18 seconds later. Brad Marchand, 3-0 Boston in game four. Too many players with too many games between goals, and Vancouver badly needs something to turn this game.
Now these are the guys that got you here, and now these are the vital signs that are so pathetic, and the reason that Vancouver has not got a goal in this game, and only one in this building.
Boston with all the energy, leading 3-0. Manny Malhotra trying to clear the puck. Adam McQuaid pinches down the boards, holds the puck in. It got away from Andrew Alberts. Needs some help from Viktor Oreskovich. He made the play to center. Tanner Glass can't get the puck away from Caberle. Albert shoots the puck back in, and there's an offside call there.
Jim, these are the moments that define your career, and as the captain of the Vancouver Canucks, now's the time where Henrik Sedin has to find a way to have an impact in this series. You think of last year's Stanley Cup Finals, Jonathan Toews going over the board physically, playing at a higher level each time, Mike Richards matching that back. You don't have to be the most physical guy like Daniel, or like Henrik isn't, but you have to find a way to get an impact and get into this series.
There's Luongo making a save on Paille. Centering pass went off a skate, held in by Andrew Ferentz. Paille, Thornton, and Campbell. It's been a four-line game for Boston to the front of the net. Luongo had to make a save on Paille. Thornton with a shot. That was blocked by Ballard. And Vancouver's Rafi Torres finally starts out. This game perilously close to getting away from Vancouver completely. Maxime Lapierre. Here's Yannick Hansen from behind the net. The Canucks really need something before the end of this period that's under 4 minutes from completion.
Don't you think a Rafi Torres hit, you know, that kind of an impact play? Big hard shift, physical shift.
Where in Henrik's case, as you pointed out, to do something to turn the game, he's got to score.
Yep, absolutely.
Bieksa gets a hit. Daniel Sedin can't hold Thornton. Alex Edler beat him to the puck, though. Here's Henrik. His pass. Daniel gets away. A slap shot wide of the net. Burrows trying to get that backhander to the open net. Couldn't do it. And Daniel showed some speed there on the left wing, trying to get in and get Vancouver's first goal. Now he's battling against Brad Marchand. Knocked the puck away from Henrik. Tipped out to center. Burrows leaves the puck for Henrik Sedin. Daniel's coming up behind him. The shoot in. Burrows gets to the puck. Daniels in front. Burrows is tripped up. Daniels takes the puck. Alex Edler, Sammy Salo to the net, blocked by Marchand. Seidenberg, double teamed by Henrik and by Alex Burrows. Bergeron pins Henrik. Burrows flopped the puck out towards the point. Edler into the middle, tipped by Daniel towards the net. Seidenberg blocked it easily, and out start the Bruins. Mark Recchi ahead for Brad Marchand, plays offside with 2:37 to go in the second period.
Now the past two games, Luongo has faced 53 shots, and he has given up 11 goals for a sparkling 796 save percentage. That's the old captain. He's got to get it done as well, give his team a chance in these games. You know, he keeps it at 1-0. They're one shot away. But it's the next two bullets to the heart that really kill Vancouver's chances tonight.
Yeah, got to get three by Tim Thomas at the other end. That's a daunting task.
Well, you need some energy. You need a goal here to finish this second period, cut it to two. Second period has just been dominated by the Boston Bruins, though, in this series. Now, 8-0 they are. 8 goals, 4, none against.
It's hard to be creative and fashion a comeback in this hot building on bad ice, too.
That's where that lead was so important. Both these teams have done well when scoring first. And think of what Ryan Kesler has done this postseason. And the energy level that he brought to Game 7 against the Chicago Blackhawks was over the top. He dominated the Nashville series. Right now, he just hasn't been able to get any open ice. And quite frankly, Jim doesn't look like he has the same kind of energy, does he?
There's suspicion that he's still hurt.
Yep.
He says he's fine, though,
as they all will.
Krejci held the puck, looking for Peverly in front. He's checked by Andrew Alberts. Adam McQuaid on the other side. Here's Andrew Ferentz. Back to McQuaid. Can't take the shot, so he passes. Krejci to the net. Luongo made the save. He didn't see it because of the battle going on between Kesler and Lucic, but he made the save. Let's bring in Elliott again.
Jim, the general managers met today, and they will make a proposal to the competition committee for Monday to the changing of Rule 48. They will eliminate the term, or propose eliminating the term, blindside. That doesn't mean an automatic head contact ban, but there will be a penalty for any hit that targets the head as the principal point of contact. Ron will have more with Rob Blake and Ken Holland in the second intermission. Jim?
That's just 2:05 away, Elliott. Glass in to take a draw. Kelly won it. Boychuk fires, and Luongo makes the save and hangs on.
Well, Manny Malhotra in to take the draw. He gets kicked out, and Tanner Glass has to come in. And he loses it fairly cleanly as Kelly wins it to his forehand. No traffic there for Luongo. He's able to gather that and hold on to the rebound.
Now Kelly gets thrown out. Tyler Seguin is a natural center but plays the wing in his rookie season, comes in, and Malhotra beat him cleanly. And so the Canucks were able to break out, but Oreskovich couldn't control the puck. Malhotra against Seguin.
This would give you life, Jim, if your fourth line scores a goal. I mean, that's the kind of thing that gets energy in your bench, sends you to the locker room with something positive going forward.
There's a shoot in. Johnny Boychuk is back. Round of the board. The puck comes to Bieksa. He faked the shot. Passes into Victor Oreskovich. Edler, side of the net. His pass hit the skate of Kelly. And Daniel Sedin down there, and he was trying to get him the puck. Victor Oreskovich continues on the forecheck. I thought you were going to be really prophetic there.
Yeah.
That fourth line was going to score.
Well, a big impact when that happens.
Here's Chris Kelly. Sedin's come on. Burrows just failed to get the puck in front of the net. And the puck is cleared over the glass.
It's out.
Boychuk's going to get a penalty.
Well, there's one little mistake that turns this into a power play. And right now, again, nothing really going positively for Vancouver, but there's one. Good forecheck, good extra effort, and Boychuk under pressure as Burrows goes hard at him, puts a little pressure, feels some footsteps, and a rolling puck out. And, boy, if you can put your entire season into one power play, this would be the time where you need to step up the intensity and score a goal. Nothing less is acceptable.
The Canucks have had great third periods in the playoffs and in the regular season, but they need to get a little closer here. What an important power play as Boychuk's off for delay of game. Henrik Sedin wins the draw. Now they get set up. Sammy Salo and Christian Ehrhoff with appointment on the power play. Daniel Sedin. Kesler battles towards the front of the net. Got Chara standing in front of him as Ehrhoff walks in. Henrik Sedin passes back to Salo, who's taken Edler's spot on the power play, and again,
there's
a tough ice.
Yep.
Puck bounced. Henrik Sedin's back in. Rink wide for Daniel, the play's offside.
One of the guys in the crowd tonight, guys, who's just in the crowd as a hockey dad. He's no longer the hockey ops guy, vice president. No, he's just here to watch his son play. He knows a little about Vancouver in the Stanley Cup Finals. He lost as a player to the Islanders as a Canuck. He beat the Vancouver Canucks as a coach with the New York Rangers, and now he's watching his son maybe tie up this series.
Son's done a heck of a job on the penalty kill in this series. He's out with Dan Pailly right now. Sedin's in after the puck. Henrik trying to jar it loose. Here's worked over by Seidenberg. Kessler comes back, throws the puck back to Sammy Salo. There's Ehrhoff in on the other side. The screen forms in front. Salo shoots. Thomas makes the save. Rebound goes to Henrik, to Daniel, to the side of the net. In behind it, Chara tripped over the goaltender, Thomas. Daniel can't get a hold of the puck. Nice play there by Paille to Gregory Campbell, and he gets the puck down the ice. Luongo's out to meet it. And it looks like Boston will get out of this period with the 3-0 lead unless Vancouver scores on this rush. Christian Ehrhoff, long shot, big rebound off Thomas, cleared by Chara, and the second period comes to an end. Vancouver will start the third on a power play, but they'll also start the third period down 3-0. Pair of goals in 2 minutes and 18 seconds. Michael Ryder's 7th, Brad Marchand's 8th. And the Boston Bruins are 20 minutes away from sending this back to Vancouver tied 2-2. Vancouver has won but 8 times in 41 years. A lot of those losses were in the old days of the old Boston Garden. Vancouver's on a power play to start this third period. 49-second power play as Edler shot the puck in. Seidenberg is back. And the Sedin's in after the puck. Daniel knocked it loose just out of the reach of Henrik. And that sends Gregory Campbell away to center. Chipped by Edler. Luongo's out to meet the puck. Daniel Sedin to center. Henrik's over on his right. Puck shot in. What was Kessler complaining about?
Too many men on the ice for Boston.
There's a shot by Edler that was blocked. Kessler was berating the referees as he came into the attacking zone. Here comes Rich Peverly. Knocked off balance, and there'll be a Vancouver penalty to Henrik Sedin. Just as Johnny Boychuk stepped out of the penalty box, ending Vancouver's power play.
And Kessler was going back for round two. Drawing as Mike Gillis looks on, can't be feeling.
Henrik just now receiving word he's getting a penalty.
Oh, that's not a penalty.
The toe pick.
Yeah, absolutely. Watch, that's literally a little tap. And Henrik's talking about what should have been too many men as well. That to me is a bad call.
So now Boston on a power play with a chance to really put this away after Vancouver failed and went 0-for-3 with a man advantage.
Time of the penalty, 52 seconds.
Bruins get their second opportunity.
52 seconds.
It's called a slash. Dennis Seidenberg. Milan Lucic at center. Got the puck by Kevin Bieksi. He'll go after it himself on a collision course with Alberts. Back to the blue line and Kaberle. Seidenberg off the boards under pressure. Puts the puck in for Lucic. He gave it away to Burrows. He's trying to be hard enough on his stick to clear it and can't do it. Held in by Patrice Bergeron. David Krejci centering pass. Kaberle with a weak shot wide of the net. Here's Milan Lucic. Krejci. Bergeron, one-timer that went off the leg of Alberts. And the Bruins are coming close because they won the battle to keep the puck in. Seidenberg on a Vancouver change. David Krejci now. Pass to Bergeron and a nice save by Luongo on him. Here's Mason Raymond out to center. One man back and that's Seidenberg. He shoots and he missed the net. Down to the last 45 seconds of this Boston power play. The Bruins lead 3-0. Mark Recchi under pressure. Mason Raymond took the puck away. Beats Ferentz. Raymond in alone, and he's checked from behind. Michael Ryder with some help there from Zdeno Chara. And they made a great play on Mason Raymond, who got away shorthanded. That would have been huge for Vancouver. There's a shoot in by Ferentz. Dives in the corner. Sammy Salo gets to the puck. Around for Matty Malhotra. And Alex Edler's there as well to clear the puck. 10 seconds left in the Henrik Sedin penalty. One shot on this power play, and a good one by Bergeron, stopped by Roberto Luongo. Chara has to turn to get the puck. Henrik is back on. Neither team able to score on the power play tonight. Andrew Alberts. Too hot to handle for Daniel Sedin.
and an icing call against Vancouver.
Well, it was Brad Marchand and Daniel Paille in game three that scored shorties to give Boston a lift. Here's a great chance for Raymond, but the key for Ryder is he kept his legs moving. He waited for the time that Raymond took the puck to the outside and did a nice job of not taking a penalty and just lifting his stick and grabbing the puck. The tendency there is to get that hook in there, and he resisted it and made a great play.
Gregory Campbell won the faceoff. Vancouver's had quite an edge in faceoffs tonight. Thornton to the front of the net. Boston trusting its fourth line against Vancouver's Sedin group. That's how much faith Claude Julien has in this line of Campbell, Thornton, and Paille tonight. And Tim Thomas makes a save and hangs on in front of Daniel Sedin.
Well, what a swing of events. Vancouver Canucks take a penalty here. And you tell me whether Pevely was falling before that little love tap by Sedin or not. Absolutely was. And then what should have been a 5-on-3, because if you start counting the black sweaters, how many you got out there? Got more than four. So it should have been a too many men on the ice penalty.
Absolutely. He was able to join in the play and get back into the zone. And the guy was still 15 feet away.
Kessler, who was right there in the middle of it and saw those men on the ice, is out to take this draw. Rich Peverly, there's another thing he can do. Take the odd face off, and he won that one. Krejci's had a tough night, so Peverly took that one. Here's Lucic. He's got by Bieksa. Settling. Score! How in the name of Orlin Curtin back-to-back get in the back of the net? It's 4-0 Boston.
I think you'll see Corey Schneider as he gets his hat off. Roberto Luongo's night is done. This is just a byproduct again of over-aggressiveness of the D. The D has struggled for Vancouver in these last two games. Kevin Bieksa has been praised for his composure and the way he's played throughout the playoffs. But down 3-0 as the fans react to Luongo's journey to the bench. Watch this, trying to make a big hit, had his head down. Lucic makes the play, and this is just a rebound off of both Kessler and Peverly. But there's the one hit to the outside. Lucic keeps his legs moving, and this is a slow-moving puck that goes right off Luongo's stick, off Peverly and in. And I think this one's going to count.
They'll have a look at it in case he batted it into the hand, but Rich Peverly appears to have his second of the game. Remember, he moved up and played the right wing where Nathan Horton would normally be, and Rich Peverly, who's acquired the trade deadline from Atlanta, makes a big play going to the net.
Yeah, to me, Luongo trying to deflect it, didn't maybe get enough on it. Up maybe a bit of the body area of Peverly, and that doesn't look like anything of a hand motion knocking that one through.
Yeah, I think that's all they're looking for. You know, goals are supposed to be scored with the stick. You can't bat them in with your gloves. You can't headbutt them into the net. And they're probably looking for that forward motion of the hands. It is no idea the puck's
hand,
there.
The left hand might have got a piece of it there. That's probably the one that they'll be looking at the hardest.
So if they disallow the goal, do you switch your goaltender again?
You bring him back in or not? That's a great point. I mean, Roberto Luongo, much was made. I talked about it in... Look at that. Does it any...
That might be off his hand.
Forward motion. It looked like it might have hit off his hand.
Maybe punched in.
Counts on the ice.
But it's... It's called a goal on the ice, so it stays.
It can deflect off a player, but you can't bat the puck into that with body first.
So no evidence to turn that over, and Rich Peverly's got his second, his fourth of the playoffs, and Boston has a 4-0 lead, and they've outscored Vancouver 12-1 in games 3 and 4.
And much like Don Cherry was talking about for Alain Vigneault, in game 3, he asked his goaltender if he wanted to stay in. Of course, Luongo said yes. Here in game 4, he didn't give him a choice.
And in retrospect, Zimmer, he admitted today that he made a mistake. He shouldn't have listened to him.
Corey Schneider played at Boston College. He's a Boston area kid. Getting a chance to play in the cup final under trying circumstances.
Corey Schneider.
Schneider has played some big games in tournaments like the Bean Pot in this building. Facing the Boston Bruins, the team he grew up watching, and he makes a save there on Tyler Seguin. He holds on for a faceoff. So officially the scoring played in is Peverly from Lucic
and Krejci.
Well, right now it's regroup time. I mean, there's nothing more devastating. You've worked your entire life to get to this moment. They hopped on a plane 4 days ago with a 2-0 lead, everything going their way, energy galore. And in a matter of just less than 6 periods, lots of questions, and that energy is going the other way in the Boston Bruins.
And Schneider with a nice save on Boychuk. And think about the two games here. They played a very good first period in game number 3 here, and it got away from them in the second, and the same thing happened tonight. You can't complain about Vancouver's road game in the first period this evening.
No, I thought they were out shooting, they were out playing, they kept the pucks deep, but so often it's just a little break that turns the tide, and the start of the second period in game 3 will be one that you look back on. The Edler broken stick, and the power play goal by Recchi off of Kessler's stick, and all of a sudden Boston's a completely different team.
There's Sean Thornton with a long shot and a centering pass. Andrew Albert's former Boston Bruin is there. Little tip to center, Tanner Glass with a 4-5 ship. Advances the puck and goes after it. Andrew Ferentz outlet can't get the puck out. Oreskovich kept it in for Vancouver. Ballard is back, an icing call against Boston.
But it's been a tough building to play in for the Vancouver Canucks. They've been outscored now 12-1. And who's not getting enough credit is Tim Thomas, because you guys are right. Perfect road games, lots of chances, lots of scoring chances. 41 shots in game 3 and only 2 from the top line for Vancouver. That's the storyline. It's the top line that's got to get engaged.
They're pretty good tonight. They just haven't scored. They're good in the first period anyway. There's Chris Higgins after the puck, and David Krejci's there to scoop it away. Krejci's line is outperforming the Sedin line.
I still think it's been far too easy in the net for Thomas, though. He's had to fight through some scrambles, but he hasn't had the body traffic that he should.
There's Higgins with a shot. Up high, missed the net.
They did it early in the first period, but they just haven't been able to get in that position.
Mason Raymond to Ryan Kessler. And a long shot set. You'll never beat him with a shot like that with no traffic.
Boychuk on the last shift, it certainly wasn't a pleasant one for him. You see the grimace on the bench. Take a look at it here, knee to the head. Well, that doesn't feel very good, does it? And at full speed too, so you know Higgins is skating about 24 kilometers an hour. You guys are right, that last save, way too easy.
There's Dennis Seidenberg, this is Ed O'Chara. Things change in a series, in a Stanley Cup final. Vancouver looked like much the faster team in the first 2 games. Boston's got some speed, lots of energy, and Vancouver looks like a tired team right now. Oreskovich for the pass that was blocked. There's Henrik Sedin after the puck. Daniel to Henrik. Pass comes back to Alex Edler. His slap pass tipped wide by Oreskovich. Centering pass, and Daniel had been knocked down. He got up and couldn't get the puck. Here comes Mark Recchi with Brad Marchand. And he can't get by Sammy Salo. After the puck is Alex Edler. Torres Randall interference for him. Alex Pearls right up the middle. Has a little button hook. Beats Christian Ehrhoff. He fakes the shot. Takes the shot. Thomas the save. Rebound loose in the crease, and Tim Thomas is down on it. Nine shots now at Tim Thomas in games 3 and 4, and he's let in but one. He's been a polarizing figure since he arrived in Vancouver, and what have you done for me lately? Apparently not enough. Corey Schneider in goal for Roberto Luongo. That building will be full of patrons with expensive tickets Friday night, game 5. 5 o'clock, Vancouver start. And it looks like the series will be tied up 4-0 here at game number 4. Tim Thomas, the Canucks try to work the puck to the front of the net. Kevin Bieksa. Got away from Sean Thornton. Steered wide by Gregory Campbell. And he turns again, and Campbell took the puck away. 3-on-2 Bruins at center, their fourth line. Paille with a pass into the skates of Thornton. And he dumps the puck in, heads for the bench on a chain.
That's the second straight shift that Burroughs has played on that Lapierre line with Torres.
Victor Oreskovich has been up for a couple of shifts with the Sedin line as the puck gets to the front of the net. So Oreskovich is a big man, a little protection, a little muscle on the Sedin line. And some alterations by Canavino.
Well, two games in this building, 69 shots, and only one has gotten by Tim Thomas. This guy is a true competitor, and the Vancouver Canucks are going to have to find an answer on how to beat him. And how to beat him is with traffic and little plays around the net where you make a move east-west, because he's such an aggressive goaltender. And they just haven't found a way. The other big thing, Boston have done an excellent job. They get in the lanes. So a lot of times when you have a shot, you can't get it through. You don't want to get it blocked.
Kessler won the draw. Salo took a shot off a skate wide.
Thomas now 93 of 94 shots he saved on home ice.
Here's Milan Lucic. Corey Schneider stops it. Any doubt in either of your minds who will start in goal for Vancouver Friday night?
I tell you, we saw the scenario in the Chicago series after the 3-0 lead evaporated. Corey Schneider got game six. I'll tell you, I'd be surprised if it wasn't Luongo, given the fact that here's where you are, but I've been wrong plenty of times before. How about you, Glenn?
The one tough call, but I was absolutely shocked. Game six in Chicago. I sat in the studio and watched him come out the tunnel first, thinking, wow, this takes a lot of jam to make this call.
And now we're in the Stanley Cup final.
Well, that one made more sense in the sense that you still had one to give. And you don't put Schneider in a tough, tough position. If he happens to lose, you come back home with Luongo. Here, though, you're going back tied at two. As the Bruins get a penalty, Mark Recchi a little over-aggressive in the corner.
Well, going back tied to two, unless there's a scoring spree here on Tim Thomas, as Mark Recchi gets a penalty right there on Bieksa.
And the crowd reacting to what you just saw. Again, the flopping of the heads. We've seen it on both sides have been guilty. Vancouver's done it. Boston's done it. And for the officials, what's a real call?
So now, if nothing else, what they have to do here in Vancouver is get this power play working,
yep.
Get something positive happening for the next game. This has gone on too long. Power play's 0 for the night, 0 for 3. 1 for 19 in the series. Now Kevin Bieksa is out with Christian Ehrhoff. We've used three different point men with Ehrhoff on the first unit power play. Salo just had a long shift. Here's Kevin Bieksa trying to feather one through to the net. Knocked down and cleared. And what a confident group of penalty killers. Led by Dan Paille, Gregory Campbell, Chara and Seidenberg on the ice.
And too much going on between the ears of this power play right now for Vancouver. Guys not playing on instinct. They're thinking too long. They're taking their time. And they're not moving the puck with any kind of speed or precision.
Ehrhoff bobbled the puck. Paille takes off. Already scored shorthanded. Takes a shot at Schneider, who makes the save and quickly plays the puck. Henrik Sedin, long pass for Ryan Kessler. Got Daniel Sedin with him and gives him the puck. Henrik, Kevin Bieksa, Ehrhoff, one-timer deflected to the corner. Daniel Sedin, Ehrhoff's open at the right point. Daniel feeds the puck in for Henrik. Kessler works in front. Ehrhoff to Bieksa, his one-timer wide of the net. McQuaid trying to find the puck. He batted it out of the air. And the play is stopped. And a high stick. Well, there's a slash being called here.
There's all kinds of battles going on. And right
in front of the net, he's calling a slashing penalty on Ryan Kessler.
Kessler got away with a bunch of cross checks. And I mentioned, until they draw the line and call it, this is what you got to do. Get in there and battle. Get in the face of Thomas. Battle around defensemen, get yourself involved physically. He got away with a lot, but he didn't get away. It was afterwards right there, the slash in the back of the legs, and Glenn, you've seen about 15 of those, haven't you, down at ice level?
Yeah, it seems like every time a player skates by, either the Sedin or Kessler, there's a Boston Bruins slashing those three guys. And likewise, it's contagious. Now Vancouver's singing the same song from their songbook, and they're doing it too.
Four on four for 45 seconds until the penalty to Recchi expires. We're in the back half of the third period of Game 4 of the Stanley Cup Final. Higgins on the fly. He's in alone. Stopped by Thomas. That's a third breakaway. Thomas has stopped on Higgins in the series. Milan Lucic back the other way. He does have a way of putting exclamation marks on things, doesn't he? Tim Thomas.
To Higgins' credit, he's tried three different moves and all three different breakaways. Nothing's working.
Lapierre with a shot, and again, an easy save for Thomas. And 8:53 remaining in the third period of Game 4 on Hockey Night in Canada.
112 minutes in this building, and the Sedins have got to find a way to not get engaged physically, but do what they do best. And what they do best is put pucks in the back of the net. Five shots in two games in the Boston TD Garden is not good enough, and that is the reason that the Vancouver Canucks have relinquished their 2-0 series lead, and we now have a series that could go as many as 6 and 7.
Still 4-on-4 here for another 8 seconds. A long shot on Thomas, and he stopped Alexander like he stopped everybody else. Recchi's back on. Boston's on a power play for just over a minute. Alexander sends the power play back into its own zone. There's Zdeno Chara. Into the attacking zone, he passes off. Mark Recchi sets up. Chara. Beverly getting some power play time here with Ryder and Recchi up front. And Kevin Bieksa sends this power play back into its own zone again. Andrew Ferris. He'll chip in and chase himself. Got there before Alberts. Going to get a high stick, too. Puck comes back to Ryder. Stripped of it by Yannick Hansen, who went down so he couldn't take off. Matty Malhotra watches Chara. Creative David Krejci. There's Krejci. Turn the puck over. Kessler out of the penalty box. One man back. It's Seidenberg. He shoots. Thomas caught it off. After the rebound, Mason Raymond can't come up with it. This line of Higgins, Raymond, and Kessler, like the Sedin line, can't score.
And Thomas just looked like he's out playing shinny. He just doesn't look calmly there. He's aggressive.
The thought occurred that it's almost like he's rubbing his nose in it by not even trying.
He doesn't even look like he's working at it.
Henrik Sedin to Keith Ballard. His shot up high, gloved by Tim Thomas. That puck must look like a beach ball to him right now.
He's entirely dialed in, and those kind of long shots, you're not going to get much of a chance. Look at his positional play. Just bats it down, knows, gets back up, and how close things are. I mean, this series, the first two games in Vancouver, Boston truly believed that they could be in the series. They almost felt they could have been up 2-0 with an overtime goal and a 19-second left in the third period in the first one, but Vancouver has not even been close here in Boston.
Thomas during the year, and it was a historic year for him numbers-wise, said, if I see the puck, I feel like I can stop every single puck. I don't think it's changed here in the postseason for him.
Viktor Oreskovich continues to play with the Sedins here, probably to try and soften up Zdeno Chara if he can. Oreskovich at center. Henrik Sedin takes over. His pass for Daniel, kicked away by Seidenberg. Erhoff under pressure from Seguin, gets away. Tyler Seguin shoots, and he's stopped by Corey Schneider. What a lot of time he had. Erhoff had slid right out of the play. I thought he was going to get a penalty. There's a shot that Schneider stops. Off the stick of Bergeron, who has the puck again, and he shot wide.
Christian Ehrhoff to Daniel Sedin. The soft shoot-in. Caberlet's back, Burrows right on it. Burrows playing with LaPierre and Torres. Gregory Kim. Caberlet to center. Daniel Paille. And Sean Thornton stripped to the puck and Burrows dumps it in. McQuaid, here comes Torres. Not much of a hit. Campbell and Burrows battle for the puck. Comes loose to LaPierre with a shot off a body in front. Sammy Sallow. Alberts wants the puck back at the blue line. Passes into the corner. LaPierre centering pass. McQuaid blocked that. At the blue line, Alberts with a nice play to keep that play alive in the attacking zone. And now another slash being called.
LaPierre broke Thornton's stick with a slash. And Dan O'Halloran was right behind him watching the entire thing.
Down to 5:25 to go in the third period of game four. Boston 4, Vancouver nothing on Hockey Night in Canada.
Three. Vancouver said, we're not even going to look at the tape. We'll throw the circular filing bin. Well, they better watch this tape. And what it shows me is that the Vancouver Canucks are losing every puck battle. And because of that, the Boston Bruins are up by four.
Very similar to the Chicago series. Remember, that was 7-2 and 5-0 Vancouver lost. And everyone was questioning the goaltender, and now it's 8-1 and 4-0, and the questions remain about Roberto Luongo's play.
And they just weren't able to push back, were they? And it was Chicago who was able to get that physical edge, dominate the play along the boards, and eerily similar. And right.
I know this series shifts back to Vancouver on Friday. This is a quick turnaround and a long flight. 5 o'clock start on Friday in Vancouver, and I would think that that flight tomorrow is going to be a little easier for the Bruins.
One team feeling pretty good about themselves and lots of energy, and for the Canucks and the fans that await, they got some answers. And Glenn, you're right about filing that last game in the garbage can, but this is one that I think you have to put on the players. And if I'm Alain Vigneault, it's not so much about what you say after the game, it's looking to the leadership. The leadership you rely on all year long. This is one of those dig down for each other, look at where you are, look at the opportunity you have. And to me, this is one of those players only meetings afterwards where you have to do a little soul searching.
You break it down and you say, we win one game and we put a loaded gun to the Boston Bruins' head. They have no margin for error. But they've got to get back to playing their game.
Bruins full of confidence. Bergeron side of the net, stripped of the puck. This is still a Boston power play as the puck is cleared by Andrew Alberts, and he'll change. Thomas Caberlet.
Krejci almost took his arm off as he came on the bench.
Ryder was stripped of the puck. He got slashed across the hands and across the blue line. Andrew Ferentz. Kessler watching as Ryder takes over. Attacks the blue line with some speed. Gets open and then poke check by Alex Edvard. Chara will let the puck out. Mark Recchi. Gregory Campbell rewarded for his play with a little power play time here late in the game. Thomas is out to play the puck.
Maybe a little defensive mode too.
Yeah.
You don't want to give up a shorty and get any life.
But it's fair to reward those guys because that fourth line has been good. They've been good penalty killers. They've been very trustworthy 5-on-5. Here's Chara with a shot. Didn't get much on it. Snyder made a wonderful save off Michael Ryder. LaPierre's penalty is over. Teams are 5-on-5 with 3 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the third period and game four. They'll play Friday in Vancouver, game six. It'll be after 2 days rest. It'll be a Monday game. Mason Raymond with another shot. And another easy save for Tim Thomas. Vancouver's got 36 shots on goal now. Henrik Sedin straight up the middle with a shot. And Thomas stops that with under 3 minutes to go. So game five Friday, 5 o'clock. Game six would be back here Monday at 8 o'clock start. And if a game seven is necessary, it would be next Wednesday night in Vancouver.
Most hated guy in the Vancouver Canuck bench, still at it. You mentioned it, Simmer. Let's take a look at it. Let me see if I can pull your shoulder right out of its socket.
And of course they look back and go, yeah, I figured it's you. And how about this bit of nastiness? That connects with Pierre's head. That is dangerous. So the silliness has continued tonight. To add on to your shots too as well, guys. Boston Bruins are 10-4 when they're outshot. That shows how good Thomas is. They'll be 11-4 tonight when outshot.
Chris Kelly plays the puck back. Johnny Boychuk lost it in his feet. Victor Oreskovich playing with the Sedins. Stops and feeds Keith Ballard. Back along the boards, Oreskovich. A return pass for Ballard, intercepted by Chris Kelly. Peverly to Brad Marchand. Erhoff went straight at him, went down. Now Marchand, Ballard's going to come after him and fight him. And Keith Ballard wrestling with Brad Marchand, who was getting the initial penalty, I believe.
Yeah, Marchand with a little clothesline on Erhoff.
Adam McQuaid against Christian Erhoff. There's a mismatch.
Well, Erhoff thought about getting into the mix with Marchand and Ballard, and then realized he was going to be third man into a fight, and McQuaid saw that and came right after. And two players not known for their fighting, and Ballard and Erhoff paired up there. But you're right, it's Marchand going over the head of Erhoff, almost clothesline him going in on that puck. That's the original call. We'll see what we get after. We saw in game three the officials got rid of players pretty quickly,
yeah, and they will
use anything, and I'm sure they will here. Watch the left arm. This clotheslines Erhoff. Here comes the hit again. Marchand goes down as Daniel gets head over heels.
Could be a pair of Marchand penalties.
Yeah, right there. There. Watch him go down.
And one there.
And he was ready for Ballard coming out. There's Erhoff going in. Now McQuaid says that's enough for that.
And Marchand, as he makes his way past the bench, I'm just going to wipe my hands clean of you guys. And the message from the Vancouver bench is we'll remember that.
But if Vancouver can't score in the power play, that kind of stuff's going to continue.
Yeah. The dangerous thing is that is clipping.
Yes.
A player coming at you.
Well, how many times have we seen that in this series, Glenn?
Yep. North, south, and you bend down and take his knees out.
All season long, Vancouver's not known as a really tough team, but all season long, they can handle any sort of rough stuff anybody threw at them because they make you pay on the power play.
Yep,
and they have in the playoffs, too, until this series.
That is the difference. If you look at the power outage in the Stanley Cup final, that's had a big impact. The Boston Bruins can play a lot tougher and can take a lot more liberties if they're not worried about Vancouver sticking it to him on the power play.
You don't make Brad Marchand skate across the ice after a goal and think about what he's doing. He'll keep doing this.
And a dangerous play for Daniel there on his knees, and his head went hard into the board. That's the reaction. And this kind of stuff, there's been too much of this in my books on both sides. And so much after the whistle and showboating each other. This is far too important. And right now, Vancouver's going to go for broke. Take the goaltender out, go six on. Is it going to be four or is it going to be three?
We still haven't put any penalties up or announced them, but Corey Schneider is leaving with 2:27 to go in the third period. And Vancouver will have, they have six attackers on the ice against three Bruins right now. There'll be a fourth, I believe.
Kelly's just getting his visor wiped. Yeah. Nice little chance to get a break. That's another trick of the players. Make sure I'm well rested. But I agree with you, Simmer. Boston is one of the toughest teams in the league. They want to put the game into the ditch.
Yeah.
You've got to find a way to use your skill. Stay away from the scrum. Stay away from the incitement that goes on after almost every whistle.
And to me, it starts with Kessler, Burrows, the guys who have done such a good job this year avoiding getting sucked into that kind of game. They've fallen into the trap here in games three and four.
Vancouver's number one power play unit is on the ice here.
Boston penalties, number 63, Brad Marchand.
There's Daniel Sedin. Sammy Salo loads up and shoots, and Thomas got a piece of that, and the puck went out of play.
So a big early push here as the 4 minutes, if you can score quickly, try to get another one. at least make it interesting. But once again, look at the front of the net. A clear path, even though it was deflected and Thomas had to use his head. A clear path for Thomas to see that puck.
Marchand got two for roughing, two for holding. Ballard got two for roughing. McQuaid's out of the game. Kessler won this faceoff. Alex Edler turns as the screen forms. He tried to have Kessler tip that and he missed it. Henrik Sedin to Sammy Salo. Alex Edler. Henrik Sedin to Daniel Burrows and Kessler both battling in front of the net. Pass comes to Alex Edler. Over to Salo. And a whistle goes and a pile up in front and another scrap. And this is Burrows in the middle of that. And Tim Thomas was going after it.
We saw Thomas with the big hit on Henrik Sedin in game three.
Kessler just threw a punch at Chara.
Kessler's going, Burrows is going, Chara's going after Henrik. Here's all the little after film.
All season long, it was the Canucks, Burrows, and Kessler trying to stay out of that stuff. They turn away, they escape to the bench. In this series, they've been drawn right back into what they were known for before. And the Bruins have done it too, but if their plan was to pull them into the ditch, they've done it.
And we had an old saying in the Stanley Cup Finals, you got to play like a machine. You know, between the whistles, you can constantly come at your opponent, hit them whatever you can, play to the end, and then turn the cheek and get back to the face-off dot and show you're ready to go.
Doesn't this just show you the frustration, though, of the Vancouver Canucks? I mean, little play here in front of the net. As Burrows chops the stick out of Thomas's hand once. There's the chop back, then he goes right at him.
At this way, he ends up with Burrows' stick in his hand. A good blocker punch, too, and there's one punch by Kessler.
Way over the top trying to get Chara, and he got him mad, too.
And Tim Thomas. Boy, if he had connected with that blocker, it would have been a beauty and a smiling face. Nothing more frustrating. Pretty easy to do, though, when you look up at the clock and you've got a 4-0 lead.
By the way, in that last group of penalties, Brad Marchand got the book thrown at him. He got 2-2 and 2, roughing, holding, tripping. All in one series. And Mike Murphy looks on. Kessler's out of here. Burrows is out of here. And again, the referee's just managing things with 1:51 to go and get all the combatants out of the game.
You know, at some point, though, in this series, the referees are going to decide we're going to put an end to this. And it's going to be a tightly contested game. So the past two games had lots of passion, but plenty of lack of discipline.
Tim Thomas is on the big screen, and the fans love it.
They just watched his roundhouse blocker that just about knocked the head off of Burrows.
What's next? Get a hit in game three, almost a fight in game four, and he's been spectacular between the pipes.
Minute 51 away from his second shutout of the playoffs, his third career playoff shutout. Still a ways to go, though, and is Vancouver still on a power play? Corey Schneider's back in the goal.
Vancouver penalties, number 14, Alexander Burrows, 2 minutes cross-checking.
Burrows gets a cross-checking penalty. Kessler for roughing, they're both gone. Here's Alex Edler straight up the middle of Vancouver's power play. Shoots the puck in for Henrik and Daniel Sedin to go after it. Kevin Bieksa, Rafi Torres parked in front of the net. Daniel Sedin. Edler open, doesn't take the shot. Bieksa to Daniel. Edler shoots and that's blocked by Gregory Campbell. And he decides to skate the puck out, flips it down where Schneider comes out to play it. Now he has to leave it.
Campbell didn't want to take a slap shot there because he blocked the shot with his stick and he thought that it would disintegrate. So he made sure he just wristed it out.
Bieksa straight up the middle. There's a shot by Edler. He missed the net. Bieksa's going to stay right in this play. I'd be watching him closely right now. Here's Alex Edler, Kevin Bieksa, Edler, one-timer wide of the net. Henrik Sedin dislodges the puck off the net. Seidenberg is there trying to clear it. Edler, Daniel Sedin, here's Henrik. Torres working in front against Boychuk. There's quite a battle there. Alex Edler, Bieksa, one-timer missed the net. Henrik Sedin gathers in the puck. He's checked, Kelly checked him. Edler held the puck in.
And it's knocked out of the air by a high stick with 22 seconds to go in game number four.
Well, the Bruin faithful have seen their team just come to life. They saw it in the Montreal series after they lost the first two games. They battled back now here when it matters the most, the Stanley Cup final. They've drawn even at two.
Swagger really changed for Boston with the nine shifts Thornton played in game three.
10 seconds to go. Bruins have beat up on the Canucks 12-1 at home. Tonight, Tim Thomas gets the shutout. And ladies and gentlemen, what we have now is a best of three series for the Stanley Cup. Terrific in two games in Boston, and he and the Bruins have tied this series 2-2. Ron?
Tim, thanks a lot. 38 saves directed at Timmy Thomas tonight. Perfect performance. Zdeno Chara, the Crown Royal three stars. Obviously, Thomas grabs the number one spot. Rich Peverly scores a pair, including the game winner, and Zdeno Chara, goal and an assist. Plus two in the game, 4-0 Boston. Series is tied. Don Cherry has his analysis on Bobby Orr's big evening at TD Garden next.